Now, a quick review and some conversation with two of the Star Trek Beyond stars. It is smoothie sailing. You'll discover why in a moment. New Star Trek movie, to me, is the most like the TV show. Lots and lots of interplay between the crew members. I didn't think it was too heavy or too scary. Some hardcore action fans may think the whole thing is a little light, but I liked it. So I'm about to talk to Simon Pegg, who's Scotty, co-wrote the movie, Carl Urban, who plays Bones. And you know, typical junket, sitting outside the Four Seasons in a hallway, waiting to go inside. And I'm about to go in when they say, hang on for a minute. And then this waiter with a tray of the most gorgeous looking smoothies walks into the room ahead of me. I follow after the smoothies.
Of course you do. You'll see.
All right, most importantly, how were the smoothies? Because there was considerable production outside as they brought the smoothies in.
Who got smoothies?
You didn't get them?
We didn't get any smoothies. What is this? This is a travesty.
Did the staff take this? They're all laughing in there.
You, how dare you?
Did you take their smoothies?
We're the talent. We're supposed to be given everything.
Do you like that phrase, talent? Do you feel it as a substitute for the word children?
I feel like it's a faintly passive-aggressive term. Here come the talent. It's like they're trying to butter us up, but really they're calling us. I think it's not as nice a word as children.
Often it's very sarcastic.
Tell your crack team that stole your smoothies.
Yeah, I'm going to. We're on to that.
Someone's not coming to work tomorrow.
Where's my smoothie?
No, but you see, there's all the publicists, all the, I mean, this most, you know, it's glistening and glowing.
That's what's great about the, when you go to these junkets, the actors are in that room locked up for 12 hours, but they do get a constant round of, you know, french fries, smoothies, champagne.
What the crew does.
Another movie opening this weekend, what of Ab Fab? Remember Absolutely Fabulous? This is the show that's been a huge hit in England forever. Started a long time ago, had a rerun here on Comedy Central. So now the ladies are back for the Ab Fab movie, and as I learned in talking with them, and this is maybe a trick that I use, they always accuse me of giving the list too late of what we want to put on the show. If you turn it in really late, nobody can mess with it. Watch this.
In the south of France, everyone's a criminal.
The fortunes, the estates, the yachts.
What is this, some kind of late life lesbo party? Where are the men?
The producer last night said, was a very complimentary.
Is this John Plowman?
Yes, very complimentary, but said, you know, movie script is approximately 120 pages, and you come in with 10 pages.
He's a terrible man.
That was wrong, because you didn't. You sent
a
much bigger
script. This time, I actually had to write a whole script, because Fox Searchlight and the BBC wouldn't release the money. Unless I
can't think why. I mean, it seems strange.
Couldn't they just trust you?
I know.
What's the thing?
No, we actually need a script.
But he described it in this interesting sort of psychological way. He said, because you're just this fountain of wonderful ideas, you're reluctant to commit any idea to paper.
I do think that's true, in a way, because the second you commit something to paper, everyone else can have an opinion. And I don't often think that's helpful. I prefer to do it last minute, so that's what's going to happen. And if it changes, it's because we want it to change, not because someone else wants it to change.
You don't need those. I am your mirror.
How do I look?
Fabulous.
Thank you.
But see, that is the lesson.
Just wing it.
You know, everybody else is like, why can't you plan the stuff the night before? Because you guys would mess it up. Let's not do
that. Procrastinators everywhere.
There it is. So we embrace the
rationale. Rejoice.